The auto mirror add-on allows you to mirror objects with literally one click, so you don't need to add loop cuts or delete parts of your mesh to apply the mirror modifier. It handles everything for you automatically. It's a big time saver. So let's jump right in and see how it works. The first thing we need to do is enable the add-on. So just go to Edit, Preferences. In older versions of Blender, you would go to Add-ons and search for Auto Mirror to enable the add-on. But since Blender 4.2, you should go to Get Extensions. If it's the first time you're going to this section, you will need to allow online access. Then search for Auto Mirror and click on Install. Now you're ready to use the add-on. Let's mirror this cube here first. So we need to select it. The add-on works in either object or edit mode. If I go to edit mode, we can see that there are no loop cuts on the cube, and the add-on will add it automatically. So let me go back to object mode. So we can see that it works in object mode, and I'm gonna press N to bring out this menu. Go to the edit tab, expand auto mirror, and I'm gonna hit auto mirror without changing anything so we can see what happens. At first, it seems like nothing happened, but if I go back to edit mode, we can see that the loop cut was automatically added, and the object is already mirrored. If you want to mirror the object along another axis as well, you just need to select the axis here. You can also choose the orientation, that is the side along the axis of the editable part, negative or positive side. Here you can see where is the positive and negative side of each axis. So this one is the negative, and this one is the positive. So as I want the editable part on this side, I'll select the negative side. Hit auto mirror again. Now I'll mirror the z-axis. And yeah, we need to do this one axis at a time, but I don't see this as a limitation. Most of the time you only need to mirror one or two axes anyway. And even if you need to mirror all of them, it's still much easier and faster using the add-on than doing it manually. Okay, so every time you hit Auto Mirror, a new mirror modifier is added to your object. But you can select all the axes you want in the first mirror modifier and delete the other ones. It's not necessary, but I prefer it this way. But it's totally up to you. It also works for more complex meshes. Let's say, for example, that you want to edit this base mesh of a head. In this example, we need to mirror the object along the x-axis. And as I have a subdiv modifier on this object, I need to rearrange the order of the modifiers, so the mirror modifier comes before the subdiv modifier. Because in Blender, modifiers are applied from top to bottom. And that's it. This seems very simple, but it's a big time saver. If you enjoyed this video, I think you're gonna like this one as well, where I show all the extrude options in Blender. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.